This is how to install Rune Audio on your Raspberry Pi. First, you need to go to runeaudio.com. Once you're there, you need to click on the big blue button that says download. Once you're on the downloads page, you need to go down to your Raspberry Pi and then click on the big blue button that says download latest version. This will take you to a SourceForge download page, and in a moment it will start downloading. Once that has, we'll go over and we'll start up Etcher. So Etcher is compatible with Windows, Mac and Linux, so whatever system you're using, you'll be able to run this. So when you open it up, you'll need to hit on select image and then select the image we just downloaded. Then select your drive. Now make sure you select the right one here and hit continue, and then hit flash. This will take a little while depending on the speed of your micro SD card, and once that is done, it will automatically unmount the drive so you can put it straight into your Pi. And while we're at it, we'll just jump over to the Raspberry Pi now and see what happens. So on the Raspberry Pi, once it's gone through the boot process, you'll come to a login screen. However, if you wait just a little bit longer, what will happen is that it will automatically start up the Rune Audio interface. And this is what it looks like, but we don't want to use it from the Pi itself. We want to use it from a web browser. So let's jump back to the computer and we'll open up a web browser. So to access Rune Audio from a web browser, you need to type into the address bar runeaudio.local. And this will give you the interface for your Raspberry Pi where you'll be able to add and change settings and do whatever you want to it. For more great Raspberry Pi videos and technology videos, make sure you subscribe to this channel and make sure you hit the bell icon too so you get notified of new videos. And as always, imagine, learn, create.